Well, you folks, it's just a great pleasure to have you here for this event, and I welcome you all. I want to give an especially warm welcome to our honored guests, Susan Kramer, who's playing flute and recorders, Stanley Kramer playing violin, and Sarah Kramer singing for us. These are folks with whom we do some of our favorite music, and we just love it. English country dance music, which spans this whole range from 1580 up to the current date. And we'll see this as we go along. We're about to do a couple of some of the several of the early pieces right now. Ashford Anniversary and Epping Forest. It's a live art form. It's existed way back then and is very actively practiced even now. I heard it played on a button accordion once. It's just so gorgeous. Anyway, I'll play the chord here.
Thank you.
Shakespeare, right in the middle of it, there was more music and dance and that kind of thing than you can easily imagine, perhaps. But at 1601, Philip Rosseter composed music for, and Thomas Campion composed the words, the lyrics for When Laura Smiles, which is all also we do for dancing, but in any case. Much. The one person I did not introduce and should have, because it was right obvious there, is a certain beloved spouse of mine, Catherine. And Catherine was good enough to bring a bunch of treats and things that you can have, and so I just invite you whenever you please to get up and get something. It's things in the back there. Thank you. This next one, let me just note that this was during Cromwell's time, Cromwell as a Puritan, and so this kind of thing was not necessarily universally acclaimed at that time. So besides this title, The Maid Peeped Out the Window, there was also The Friar in the Well, quite possibly to make a concession to those Cromwellian folks. Again for that. This next one, I'm not quite so sure of the date. Thank you. of that. That has a kind of grandeur that lends itself to some of the more formal forms of the English country dances. I just love it for that. Years ago, and the music is still as alive and gorgeous as the day it was composed. This next one, very solemn kind of thing. So, and twice. Thank you. history. It's a really tragic history. It's another title is King James March to Limerick. If you read the history of the things that happened to the Irish, you can appreciate some of the tragedy that's in this one.
Thank you.
thank you. You set it forward. Appreciate that.
Sure. Down by the swirly gardens, Maid Ive and I did meet. She passed the swirly gardens with little snowy feet. She
Burns just amazes me. Mercy, the intensity and beauty of what he wrote.
Farewell to you, my own true love. I am going.
kind of update you with what is actually happening right now in various parts of...
It's being composed now.
Yeah. These are two pieces that were composed in 2003 and 2002 by a composer, Debbie Jackson, who lives in Ypsilanti, Michigan. And we've come just to absolutely love them. The first one has an English country dance that was composed about 5 years ago for it. And this last one, Brooklyn Yard, has one that's just been composed for it by a colleague of ours, Alan Winston, who works right up here at Slack and is also an English country dance caller.
Thank you.
in G. My sincerest thanks to Stanley and Susan and Sarah for joining us on this occasion. And my thanks to the dear Catherine for making this sumptuous repast. Thank you very much, good folks. Blessings to you all.